Nothing yet. Too many visitors stirring up the forest. The gods don't like it.
Well met.
The Inquisition has brought an offering to enter your trials.
Yes. Oh, this will be a fight to remember. I mean, enter the arena grounds. Hakon's trials await.
Farewell.
Safe journeys.
Thank you. blade for this.
Ha! What a fight! That maneuver would... Well, you saw. Well fought, Inquisitor.
Farewell.
Safe journeys.
Did I tell you? Lowlanders from the north. My God.
Be welcome, Inquisitor. Though I fear I've time for little more than a greeting, I must prepare these souls for their greater journey. Particularly those who depart without the reverence due. Their way is often hardest.
I'm not familiar with Avar funerals. May I ask what proper rites entail?
When the time comes, we are given sky burials. For most, the body is laid out and prayers given. When the birds come, they carry the soul to the Lady of the Skies. The body, unneeded, is gone.
For most?
Some souls, such as Calden's, are chosen to return. The Augur reads the signs of birth. It is a rare honor. In order to return, an offering is made to Korth the Mountain Father and buried beneath the body. A piece of the soul thus remains, allowing the rest to return to this world and be reborn.
Will someone not be given proper rites?
Calden Enverson is one of the few whose soul may return. Bloodkin must make an offering to the Huntmaster who prepares it. Or so it should be. Calden's son, Finn,
has failed in this duty, but then there's you.
Me?
You're a guest of our hold. A gift from you cannot be refused. Even an offering for Golden. I cannot dictate the nature of a gift, but if my suggestion appeals to you, speak to the Huntmaster.
I should be off.
Lady keep you.
Inquisitor, I'm honored by your visit. I'm Finn Caldenson. Forgive me if I don't stand to greet you properly.
How are you injured?
A storm blew up a few months back. It's the worst we've seen in a while. I was helping to secure the fishing boat. Einar nearly fell in. I caught him, but the current caught me. My leg got crushed against the rocks. It hasn't set properly.
I know about your father's burial, and the offering.
I tried. I dragged myself out of this cursed bed, but the pain... I collapsed. The Huntmaster found me and dragged me back. Said we didn't need another dead man.
I'm told I can make the offering as a gift for the Hold. I'll try to do so for your father.
He won't be my father much longer.
What do you mean?
I can't make the offering. When the sky burial's complete, I'll lose the right to bear my father's name. Whether or not he's my father, I still love him. I would not see his soul severed from the earth if it's meant to return. If you can make a gift of the offering, there's no way I could repay you.
I'll let you rest.
Lady keep you.
Heard you passed Hakon's trials. If you hunt as well as you fight, you'll fit in well.
I spoke to the woman preparing bodies for funeral. She said I might make an offering for Golden.
How would... As a gift? Sly woman. In that case, I'll accept an offering from the hand that gives it. Tradition says the offering's made to Korth. Only creatures who touch the god's realm will do. I'll mark where someone last spotted. It'd be an unmatched gift, Lowlander. I still pity Caldon's son, though, losing his father's name.
Farewell.
Farewell.
Have you seen the plans for the new camps? Tree houses. It all sounds awful and precarious.
I thought we could catch up.
Of course. You must have made a great impression on the Avar. Some of them paid us a friendly visit. A couple even helped repair our fortifications. And one woman brought us a barrel of fermented fish. Kenric ate some. To be polite, he said. Well, he was a very polite shade of green.
Don't you like the idea of tree houses?
It's a good idea, in theory. Up where the wild animals can't get us. But having solid ground so far, far below me with nothing but air in between us is just...
Who would have thought? Scout Harding afraid of heights.
Me? No. No. I'm not afraid. Who's afraid? No one's afraid. I love being up high. Lovely views, fresh air, birds flying at my head. I'm a little uncomfortable with heights. Don't tell anyone.
I should go.
See? See you soon, Inquisitor.
One of the animals the Huntmaster described.
Fascinating. I suspect it came into contact with the Fade.
We could camp here.
Inquisition soldiers, we lending a hand?
Lieutenant Farrow, sir. We've beaten back those Hakonite bastards. My men and I will hold here. The Hakonites along the river still pose a threat. After this last battle, we need time to fortify and regroup.
What's the situation along the river?
Between the Hakonites and the wildlife, this isn't the easiest place to maintain a presence. The river's the best way for the Inquisition to send supplies from Skyhold. Or it would be if we could travel safely along it. The Hakonites set up camps near the banks, and they attack anyone who gets within view.
That will be all, Lieutenant.
Sir?